Section 2.1, Scientific Notation. This video will help you understand scientific notation, write large numbers in scientific notation, write small numbers in scientific notation, and then take numbers that are written in scientific notation and translate them back to standard decimal form. So understanding scientific notation, very large and very small numbers are often tedious to write. Since these types of numbers come up often, especially in science, a shorthand way to write them was devised. So I've given you two examples here. First is the national debt, and this is a very large number. It's 17,100,000,000,000. So that's a very large number. So instead of writing all of this out with all of those zeros, we can write that in scientific notation just like this. 1.71 times 10 to the 11th power. Here's another example. This time a very small number, the mass of a proton. So this is a very small amount of weight here. And so we have all of these zeros and then 165 grams. So this number here is really tedious to keep track of. In fact, hard to even say with all of those place values after the decimal. So we write that in scientific notation simply like this. 1.65 times 10 to the negative 24th. Now, multiplying by these powers of 10 moves the decimal place, basically. And when we multiply by a positive power of 10, it moves the decimal place to the right and makes the number larger. When we multiply by a negative power of 10, it moves the decimal place to the left and makes the number smaller. So you see very small numbers have a negative power of 10, and very large numbers will have a positive power of 10 when we write things in scientific notation. Now let's take a look at a definition. A positive number is written in scientific notation when it is expressed in the following form. So we're going to have some number times 10 and then to some integer power of 10. So now A has to be between the numbers 1 through 10. So basically here, we want just a single digit for that number here. We don't want any numbers that are larger than 1, a place value going larger than the 1's place. Notice we can have 1 included as part of our number here for A, but we can't have 10. So getting close to 10, but not including 10. And then N, again, it has to be an integer, which are either positive or negative numbers that go by increments of 1. So here are our negative integers. They go on forever in the positive direction, go on forever in the negative direction. Okay, so examples here. We already took a look at this. This is our national debt, 1.71 times 10 to the 11th power. Notice we have just one decimal place to the left of the decimal, just something in the ones place there. And then the same thing here, 1.65, so just one out front there. We only want single digits in front of the decimal right there when we write things in scientific notation. Now let's take a look at some things that will help you understand how we write things in scientific notation. So our number system is base 10 because we have 10 fingers, which means every time we count 10 digits, we have essentially used up all our fingers, and now it's time to move to the next place value. So here's our place values. You know, we have the ones place, and we can count, you know, 0 through 9 for the ones place, and once we get to past 9, we got to jump to the next place value and go to the tens place, and then we could have the digits, you know, 0 through 9 in the tens place, and once we get to 9, when we jump to the next place value, and so on and so forth. So that makes our number system base 10. Because our number system is base 10, when we multiply by a power of 10, it simply moves the decimal place to the right. So here we go. This is 10 to the first power, which means just 10. And if I take a number like 2.51, and I just made this number up, 2.51, if I multiply that times 10, all that's going to do is take this decimal place and move it one place to the right. So we end up with 25.1. Notice a power of power of 1 on the 10 moves the decimal place one place. Now if I take and multiply by 10 to the second power, which is 100, that is going to move the decimal place two places to the right. So I take this 2.51, and if I multiply by 10 to the second power, or 100, I'm going to move the decimal place two places to the right, and I get 251. 10 to the third power, well, all that's going to do is move the decimal three places to the right. So I go 1, 2, and then when I move 3, I need to add a placeholder 0 there, and I end up with this number, 2,510. So to create a shorthand version of large numbers, we move the decimal place and multiply by a power of 10. For example, if I wanted to write this number, 2,510, in scientific notation, I would write 2.51 times 10 to the third. Now let's take a look at some examples that will help you understand how to write large numbers in scientific notation. Example 1. So we're asked here to write this number in scientific notation. So what we want to have is one digit to the left of the decimal, which would just be in this case 2.0, since there aren't any other digits behind that. I'd have 2.0 there, and now I want to multiply by a power of 10 so that I still end up with 2,000. So let's see, if I started with a decimal place right here, I would need to move that decimal 1, 2, 3 places to the right to get 2,000. So I'm going to multiply by 10 to the third power. Okay, example 2. I'm asked to write this number, 3,450,000 in scientific notation. So I'm going to start by getting my decimal in the right spot. That's 3.45, one digit to the left of the decimal, times 10. Now let's figure out what power of 10 I need. Well, to move this decimal, it's starting right here at 3.54. To make this number, I would need to move that decimal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I'm going to multiply by 10 to the ninth power. All right, example 3. Looks like we have 12 trillion here. So in scientific notation, that would be 1.2 times 10 to the, well, let's figure that out. Here's where the decimal is. Here's where I need it to be, so I don't change that number. So let's see, I need to move that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 places. So times 10 to the 13th power. All right. All right, let's go ahead and pause your video player now and answer these practice questions writing large numbers in scientific notation. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. All right, practice question 4. Well, we want to have the decimal right here, 5.0 times 10. Well, let's see. Here's where the decimal's starting in this number. I want it to move over 1, 2 places, so I don't change the value here. So that's times 10 to the second. All right, let's see. 7.5 times 10 to the, here I need to move the decimal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, so I don't change the value. So that's 7.5 times 10 to the 8th. A lot there. That looks like we've gone past the trillions. So let's see, 2.0 times 10 to the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So times 10 to the 15th power. Now let's take a look at writing small numbers in scientific notation. So before we start rewriting very small numbers in scientific notation, we need to remember two concepts. Number one is that we can rewrite any division problem using a reciprocal and multiply. So remember, if I had a division problem like this, 1/2 divided by 2/3, I didn't try to do this division. What I did is I changed this division problem into multiplication. And I did that by multiplying by the reciprocal of 2/3, which is 3/2. And then 2 here is that a negative exponent gives us a reciprocal. So remember, if I take a number like 10 to the negative second power, what that actually indicates for me is that I have 1 over 10 to the second power. So when we divide by a power of 10, it moves the decimal place to the left. So just like when we multiplied, it moved the decimal place to the right to make a larger number. When we divide, it moves it to the left to make a smaller number. And that goes right along with our intuition. So let's see here. If I take 10 to the first power, which is 10, and I divide by that 10, all that's going to do is move the decimal one place to the left to make this 251 a smaller number. We're dividing by 10, that number is going to get smaller. Well, all we got to do is take that decimal place and move it one to the left to get our answer of 25.1. Notice, dividing by a power to 10 to the first power moves our decimal one place. Dividing by, now, 10 to the second power, which is 100, when I divide by 100 here, I'm going to move the decimal two places. So it starts out right here in 251, and I'm going to move it over 1, 2, and that's going to give me 2.51. So now, while it would be easier to understand scientific notation if it were written with division, it causes problems when we go to compute things and do some calculations. So it's much easier if we write this multiplication using a negative exponent. So let's take a look again here. Remember, 10 to the negative first power really means 1 over 10. or essentially dividing by 10. When I multiply by 10 to the negative first power, I'm essentially just dividing by 10. So if I take 251 times 10 to the negative first power, it's just going to take, just like when I divided by 10, it's going to take and just move this decimal one place to the left and give me 25.1. Now here, 10 to the second power, that's really just 1 over 10 squared. And 1 over 10 squared is just 1 over 100. That's what I have written here. So multiplying by 10 to the negative second power is the same as dividing by 100, and essentially just moves the decimal two places to the left. So here's 2.51, I'm going to go 1, 2. Sorry, and that was 251 now. When I move it two places to the left, I get 2.51. Now let's take a look at some examples that will help you understand how to write a small number in scientific notation. Example 7 here. So I want this number to be written in scientific notation. Well, scientific notation always tells me I need one digit in front of the decimal, so that's going to be 1.2. Now I need to multiply by 10 to some power. Well, notice I'm going to start with this 1.2, and when I get done multiplying, I want a smaller number. That tells me I have to use a negative exponent. So I want to take this 1.2 and move this decimal now to the left a whole bunch of places. Let's see. I'm starting kind of right here with my 1.2. I need to move that 1, 2, 3, 4 places to the left. So I'm going to multiply by 10 to the negative 4th there. All right, example 8. So 3.47 times 10 to the, well, I want to make this number smaller, so I know it's a negative exponent. How many places do I need to move this decimal to make this number? Well, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, example 9. That's just going to be 8. And we can write that as 8.0, or just 8 times 10 to the negative now. Let's see. Here's my decimal. I'm trying to move that now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10 to the negative 9th. Okay, go ahead and pause your video player now and answer these practice questions. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. All right, question 10. Well, we need 9.13 times 10 to the, well, I want to make this 9.13 and I want to make it smaller so that it becomes this number, so that's a negative exponent. How many places? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 10 to the negative 5th. Question 11. 2.56 times 10 to the negative, let's see, all I really want to do here is just move that decimal one place. Okay, starting at 2.56, I just need to move that one place value, so that's just the negative first power. 12, 4.16 times 10 to the negative, let's see, here I'm starting at 4.16, and I want to move that decimal now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, to the negative 7th. Okay, so now what we're going to do next is write numbers that are in standard decimal write numbers that are in scientific notation in terms of standard decimal numbers. So go ahead and pause your video player there and answer these practice questions, turning them into a standard number. And when you're done, hit play to see how you did. Okay. So we're taking this 4.1 times 10 to the negative 6. I want to write this in standard decimal notation. So let's see, that's 4.1. And this tells me I need to move my decimal 6 places to the left. So I'll start right here where my decimal is and move it 6 places. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's going to be my decimal in every one of these place values then. I want to write a 0. Now, I'm not going to leave my answer all messy like that. Let's see, 0. And I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 1. So there is that number that was in scientific notation now written in standard decimal notation. Okay, question 14. 6.12. Now I'm multiplying by 10 to the positive 5th power. That's going to make this number bigger. And it's going to make it bigger by moving 5 decimal places. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Add my zeros in there, and I'm just going to write 612000. Now I'm going to go back and add my commas. So counting from the right, I come over 3 places, put my comma. That's 612,000. Question 15. 2.136 9 decimal places here, and that's positive 9, so I want to move to the right to make this number bigger. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Add my zeros in there. Okay, now I'm going to rewrite this number. 2, 1, 3, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Put my commas back in. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That looks like 2,136,000,000 as a standard decimal number. Okay, 7.1, I'm going to move this 6 places to the right. So 7, 1, and then 5 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come back and put my commas in. So that looks like 7,100,000. 5.12 now times 10 to the negative 5th, so that's going to make this number smaller. So I'm moving my decimal to the left 5 places. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Add my zeros. Now let's rewrite that number. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2. Okay, question 18. Let's see here. Starting with 2.1, and now I'm multiplying by 10 to the negative 7th. That's going to make this number smaller by 7 place values. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Add my zeros in there. Okay, there's my decimal. So let's see. Let's clean this up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, 1. Okay. One thing to note, too, especially if you're going to the health professions, notice every time I write a decimal number here, I always make sure I put a zero out in front of the decimal. In the health professions, we want to make darn sure we don't miss that decimal place, so we always put that zero out front. It's good for everybody, but in the health professions, it's really important, so we don't make any medical calculation errors there.